We are at 5,249 meters above sea level in Qinghai province in Chinese Tibet. As tradition calls for in these places, we made an offering to the goddess of the mountain. We deposited a yellow parakeet in the offertory. The goddess would protect us on our journey towards the Khamba nomads of Tibet. We found them in the valleys close to the city of Yushu. They are the nomads found at the top of the world, easily recognizable thanks to their black tents made from yak hair, crowned by the strands of printed prayers on white fabric. They are the so-called wind horses, which flutter with the gusts of air in eternal prayer. Just as the tsatang live on deer, the khambas totally depend on their yaks. They get milk from the yaks to make butter, yogurt, and cheese, and get nourishment from their meat, whether fresh or sun-dried. They braid ropes and fabric with yak hair for their tents, which are waterproof, although light passes through the knots. Yak tendons are used as tensors. The Khambas are profoundly religious. Before starting their daily activities, the families come together to pray in front of a sacred tanka, a cloth with paintings of saints and deities, and with mandalas, the maps of the Buddhist cosmos. The traditional hairstyle of the Khamba women consists of 108 braids smeared with dry butter from the female yak. The number 108 is sacred and symbolizes the Buddhist deity Shakti, the mother of the world. The ends of the braids are joined all together. Then they fasten some leather strips to their hair with amber and turquoise from the Baltic area and fossilized coral from the Tethys Ocean. The tent rooftops open so that the smoke can be ventilated and to regulate the temperature in summer. The women cook in the mud fireplace, which they build on one side of the room. They use dung from the livestock as fuel. At this height, getting firewood is not possible. During the warmer months, they fill the storeroom with provisions for the winter, mainly yak meat, cheese, and butter. They also store barley. Once it's made into flour and toasted, it's mixed with milk, tea, and yak lard to make tsampa, the staple food of Tibet. Despite the extreme cold of the high Tibetan plateau, it's quite comfortable inside the tents. The families are quite large. They practice polyandry. All the brothers can share the same wife. Thus, the children are common to all, and this way they avoid having to share the livestock. The children call the oldest brother father, and the other brothers uncle. They move up to 10 times a year. Their tents are easy to dismantle. Sometimes several families come together to help each other take down the tents and be better protected against pests and bandits during their travels. They use the largest yaks to carry the heaviest loads. After several hours of work, wrapping their belongings, the caravan sets out towards their new enclave, where they will assemble their tents and settle for a period of time that lasts no more than 2 months. We see barley crops in every valley, especially those close to the monasteries. The Tibetan monks eat practically only tsampa. They prepare it in a deep bowl and knead portions of it in the shape of balls. Once they are eaten with water or tea, they swell in the stomach, producing the sensation of being satisfied. At least one member of each Khamba family enters the monastery to become a monk. Many nomads make pilgrimages to the temples in the city of Yushu. The prayer wheels do not stop turning all day. Before Buddhism reached Tibet, the Bon religion was practiced, based on shamanic practices. Buddhism blended with these beliefs, bringing about Lamaism. Today, the Bon tradition is only practiced on the sacred Mount Kailash. There are manis throughout the region, sacred places marked by the parakeets and by the wind horses, scarves of color offered by the devout with written prayers. These are places with a special magnetism, which invite you to withdraw and meditate. In the city of Yushu, we find the biggest mani in the world, a rectangle 250 meters long by about 100 wide, where a multitude of stones lie. Each one has a sutra, a prayer engraved on it. They were brought here centuries ago by pilgrims from all over Tibet. Tons and tons of stones of all sizes. Stone prayers, unaltered by time, testimony to the devotion of a people scared of what lies beyond the shadow of death, who dedicated a large part of their lives to prayer and meditation. River sources tend to be sacred places where nature's influence encourages solitude and mysticism. The stones bear sacred texts. Along the way, these stone writings reverberate in the pilgrim's spirits like an unending litany. The sacred mantra of the jewel in the lotus, Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. Om Mani Padme Hum. According to their beliefs, all animals have a soul and should therefore be treated with the greatest respect. When they kill their yaks, they perform a special little ceremony using some of the water that has been blessed by monks from the monastery. Then they bind the animal's muzzle firmly and slowly suffocate it. If they killed it faster, its soul would not have time to fly free. Prayers are murmured throughout the death ritual. The sacred conch makes the call to prayer three times a day from the heights of the Yegogompa Monastery, the biggest in the city of Yushu. Before our departure, we bring a white parakeet to the temple as a symbol of respect and gratitude for their allowing us to film here.